spring of 1862. General McClellan refuses to fight with his enormous Army of the Potomac, but General Ulysses S. Grant is anything but timid. He camps on the west side of the Tennessee River at Pittsburgh Landing. Across from him, Sidney Johnston masses his troops in Corinth and plans a surprise attack. Grant's large encampment, 42 kilometers in size, is not properly defended. In the early morning, commanding an equal force of raw recruits, Confederate General Johnston knows he has to stop Grant now before reinforcements arrive. But before the battle is about to begin, a small group of soldiers is about to infiltrate the enemy's positions.
Listen up, soldier. You will slip into the center of the Union camp, eliminating all obstacles as you go. That means slitting throats. You will steal into the general's tent and procure strategic documents. You clear? You will then sabotage their survey balloon, and on your way out, destroy the enemy's ammo depot. You will avoid all lighted areas. A platoon of men should be doing this, but you're all I've got. Now don't let me down, son.
Davis gonna give you a medal for that, I guess. Now, let's get on out to the boats.
Taking heavy losses, the Union finally retreats to the Tennessee River. They hold that position as a dozen massive assaults are launched and 62 cannons blaze away. Confident of a total Southern victory, General Beauregard is shocked to face 72,000 enemy soldiers the next morning, as Buell has arrived the night before with reinforcements. Grant takes the field and forces the South to withdraw after a murderous engagement. All in all, after 2 days of fighting, there are 23,000 casualties, more than in all previous American wars combined. The costly Union victory shakes the divided nation to its very core. The war is a calamity that will require more bloodshed and sacrifice than anyone could have ever imagined. For Grant, the victory only steals his determination. The way to the South is now open.